President Watson. Paul and Timothy, servants of Jesus Christ, to all the saints in Christ Jesus, which are faithful, with the bishop and deacon. Grace be unto you, and peace from God our Father, and from the Lord Jesus Christ. I thank my God upon every remembrance of you, always in every prayer of mine for you, all making requests with joy. For your fellowship in the gospel from the first day until now, being confident of this very thing, he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Even as it is meet for me to think this of you all, because I have you in my heart in as much as both my own. In the defense and the confirmation of the gospel, ye all are partakers of my grace. God is my record. How greatly I long after you all in the bowels of Jesus Christ. And this I pray, that your blood may abound yet more and more in knowledge and in all judgment, that ye may approve things that are excellent, that ye may be sincere without offense, till the day of Christ, being filled with the fruits of righteousness, which are by Jesus Christ, unto the glory and the praise of God. Verse 11 once again. Being filled with the fruits of righteousness, which are by Jesus Christ, and the glory and the praise of God. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we come to you, giving you thanks. We thank you for this excitement of this building wall. Hear the voice of a little child in this building. Oh, we so long to be here. Now this moment, Lord, help us open our heart. Help us open our eyes, attentive ear to hear the word, and give me the word I need to preach this morning. Things to come may always be positive, but we all know you still in control, and we follow you step by step. So remember us as we sing, as we attend this church, as we watch these children grow. They may grow in your hand, in your leadership. And if anyone who do not know Jesus Christ as their own Savior, as the Lord Jesus Christ, to live forever up in heaven, if they're not sure their destination, this service may be a thing to hear. This service, the moment of the judgment and decision. Lord, thank you again and asking your guidance in the service. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Good. And Randy said there's 20 children. I don't know what children means. Did you count me as a children? No? Okay. Okay. If you think you are the young people, I want you to be on the stage. I want to see you. 20 people filled up. Yes, right here. Yes, if you can. If you can clap your hand, that's what you need to do. Alright, you made it straight on the other way. Okay, the preteen was saying practice. It's called If You Have To and You Know It. You know that song? Yes. If you have to and you know it. Mine's a little bit different, okay? If you happy and you know it, clap your hand. Can you do it three times? It's a three beats. One can tell you what the band says. One, it's called cha cha, it's cha cha cha. Ready? Let's practice. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hand. Teenager, stop doing it. Over there, make some noise. Hey, if you're happy and you know it, clap your hand. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hand. Philippians having the great task. Where was Paul? Paul was in prison. In prison, in Paul's age, they don't have TV to watch. They don't have air conditioning. It's a dungeon. And they left in that dungeon. I don't know how much meal they had. I don't know what the bathroom situation. It's the most miserable place. Paul there. And he writes a letter. Paul, Timothy is the servant of Jesus Christ, all the saints in Christ Jesus, which are Philippi, his bishops and deacons. Let me tell you, grace be unto you, peace from God our Father, from the Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, I'm in the dungeon. Yes, I am bound. But I have believed in this guy's name. His name is Jesus Christ. We believe in you, Philippians. You can do these things in Christ alone. Let's go ahead and open the book of Philemon. I think I'm saying halfway right. Philemon is the book just before the Hebrews. It's only one chapter, one page. It's hard to find, but when you find the Hebrews, go back one. Exactly the same thing. Paul is writing letter of Paul to Philemon. But in this letter, Paul opened like this. Paul, a prisoner of Jesus Christ, and Timothy, our brother, unto Philemon, our dearly beloved fellow laborer. You know what a laborer does? I'm a bricklayer for 20-something years, till I have opened construction. I laid brick, and I have labored. What the laborer does is, I need a brick. I have to carry the brick. I need mud, which is cement. And mud. Okay, this mud is drying up. You need to mix up, get it soft. They have to get it soft. Whatever the bricklayer says, the laborer do that help to build that building. I was working when I was got the heart attack or heart problem, that is year 2000. We were trying to put the brick on the ULR six-story building, Dickinson Hall, $750,000 brick. I never seen that many brick in my life. We had thought never finished, but we finished. But the bricklayer laid a brick to build this great looking building. But they cannot lay one brick without labor. Know what I mean? They are the ones put the things in order. Without their help, bricklayer cannot do anything. In the same way, this Paul is saying, fellow laborers. You understand? We are all fellow laborers. We work for Jesus Christ. Look, where's Paul? He started out his letter, Paul, a prisoner of Jesus Christ. Yes, I'm in jail, but I'm working for Jesus Christ, same as you are. You are having a church service every week. Yes, I'm in a jail cell sitting down in a cold dungeon, but still the same. I am praying for you. I am working for you. I'm a laborer for Jesus Christ. Do you see that? You attending the church, well, that's wonderful. You meeting the people, well, that's wonderful. But the so many things, it's come from right here. You got to. We are not just a gathering of Christ. We are meeting for one reason, in Christ alone. I had last week, first week of the school, it's chaos and everything. And meet, I think, Tuesday or Wednesday. I got a letter from Japan. Whoa. Letter from Japan. Inside the envelope, I opened it up. There's a picture of 23, 24 people. Picture. All of them 60 or above. One teacher is 78 years old. That's my class, my home. Having a reunion this summer in July, and he sent me the picture. I said, wow. I'm 7,000 miles away. I cannot go. I told them they invite me in March, but no, I cannot go. They said, next year, blah, blah, blah. So I can go next year on the vacation.
Time.
Time, yeah, take a vacation. But what I'm saying is, we were 15, 16, 17, graduate, 18 years old, grow old to 60 years old, 61 years old. Two is deceased, rest of them alive. And teacher never changed. I don't know about him. Yes. Those 43 years, my goodness, there is so many different ways. Same thing will happen. We meet in this Piney Grove Baptist Church. If you're happy and you know, up your hand. Yes, you did. One place, one time. We never meet the same way anymore. But there is the same thing that Christ Jesus, in Christ alone. We are not meeting at the Christ reunion. We are not meeting as the picnic. We are meeting in the name of Jesus Christ. That's what Paul is saying. Grace be unto you, and the peace, God our Father, from Lord Jesus Christ. Our Lord Jesus Christ. Second Corinthians, let's go back a few books. Go to Second Corinthians, chapter 8. Grace of God. Book of 2 Corinthians chapter 8, it said, moreover, brethren, we do you to wit in the grace of God bestowed on the church of Macedonia. How that in a great trial of affliction, the abundance of their joy and their deep poverty abound unto the riches of their liberty. Or to their power, I bear record, yea, beyond their power, they were willing of themselves. Praying us with much entreaty that we would receive the gift and take upon us the fellowship of the ministering to the saints. Listen to this. Verse 5 said, and this they did, not as we hoped, but first gave their own selves to the Lord and unto us by the will of God. That's the difference of the people all over, the church people. We are in the church. We have been in the church. What do you mean having the church? Gave ourselves to Lord Jesus Christ. And the Lord Jesus Christ gave his life upon that cross. He shed blood for me and for you, so you may have a hope eternal. You may have a life eternal with Jesus Christ. So every time, time and time again, we meet. Yes, we will meet again and again. But the next time you meet, we meet. Meet in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. That's what Paul is saying. You are great. Yes, you have a trial. You have a tribulation. You have a such poverty inside. But you are rich because of the power of Jesus Christ. Jesus made all things different. We are sitting here, listening to some Japanese hippie talking about. No. You listen to the word. Soak into your heart. And you will have eternal life. Christ Jesus, in Christ alone. Gave their own selves to the Lord. Do that. I'm going back to the Philemon. Remember the Philemon was on? Just before the book we just read. We started 1 and 2. Let's go to number 3. Grace to you, the peace from God, our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ. Number 4. I thank my God, making mention of this always. Mention of thee always in my prayers. Hearing of thy love and the faith which thou hast toward the Lord Jesus, toward all saints. You know what I'm thinking? Paul is sitting on the jail cell or in the dungeon and hearing about the Philemon, the church is doing so good. I don't know how he hear it. Obviously he didn't have a Facebook to open it up. How many people like it? Not that. But some way or another, Paul knew that Philemon's doing Lord's job. And that filled with joy in Paul's heart. But the main part is like this, verse 6. That the communication of thy faith may become effectual by acknowledging of every good thing which is in you in Christ Jesus. You see this? Paul is saying, yes, I am in far, far away. But I'm listening to you. I'm praying for you. I'm filled with joy because you are working for Jesus Christ. It's such a wonderful thing. Fill my heart. Paul's rejoicing in a dark, dark dungeon.
You know what I mean?
I celebrated the preach 1988. And the many hospital visits, funeral service, sad occasion. And some people, best testimony I got is those hard, dark moments. Some people are so strong in their faith, understand what God's providence is, understand what is the purpose of this sickness, and this death, and this suffering. And shift my heart. Many things going on in your life, I do not know. But the God knows. And we serve God, Almighty. This morning. Last book we need to open, Matthew chapter 11. Jesus has been preaching, and this is the last word. He is closing his message, saying like this: "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. I will give you rest." I'm reading chapter 11, verse 28. Jesus said, "Come unto me." Jesus said, "Come unto me, the cross. I died for you. I shed blood for you. So you come. Whatever you have, whatever you suffering, bring it to me. Because my yoke is easy." "Come unto me, all ye that labor, heavy laden. I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. I am meek and lowly in heart. Ye shall find rest unto your soul. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." I said before, I do not know what you will see. But in God's eyes, there is a reason you are here. And my sincere prayer is, if you do not know Jesus as your own Savior. I said, Jesus died on that cross. Jesus shed blood on the cross. On the hill, there are the three crosses. Jesus in the middle. Thieves. One thief said, "Remember me, Lord Jesus." And Jesus told him, "I'll be in paradise with you." Other thief laughed at him. "What you talking about? We're going to die whatever you do. That guy cannot save me. We're going to die." But Jesus said to the other guy, "We'll meet in paradise." See the difference? We will die. Yes, we will meet the death. But after death, I have eternal life. Life with Christ. Glorious time. Any other
don't know Jesus Christ, after death, you have a life.
Yes, also, but that is the suffering.
That is the condemnation. That is the eternal darkness without Christ. See the difference. It is a time to decide. Let's all stand.